Welcome everybody to another video of Ancient Greece Loaded. Today we will talk about the famous Gegenees Giants, the giants with the six hands. By the way, if you like the video, please hit the like button and subscribe to our channel so to stay tuned for upcoming videos. Giants were common characters from the stories of ancient Greece, with individuals and races of giants seen as worthy opponents for both heroes and gods. One such race of giants was the Gegenees, a tribe of fierce, uncivilized giants who were encountered by the Argonauts, an encounter specified in the Argonautica by Apollonius Rhodius. The Gegenees were named as children of Gaia, as indeed were many of the giants of Greek mythology, including the Gigantes. The Gegenees were of prodigious size, but their distinguishing feature was the fact that they had six arms, two protruding from their shoulders and a further two pairs from their ribcage. The Gegenees were also described as lawless and troublesome, but these were traits of virtually all giants that appeared in Greek mythology. The home of the Gegenees was an outcrop in the Sea of Marmara, located to the east of the mouth of the river Aesepus. This outcrop of land comprised of a lowland plain and also a high mountain, and was virtually an island, for there was but a narrow, low-lying isthmus attaching it to the mainland of Mysia. The Gegenees shared their island home with a tribe of men, the Doliones, with the Doliones living on the lowland plain and the Gegenees upon the mountain slopes. Trouble between the two tribes was avoided though, for despite being troublesome in nature, the Gegenees were afraid of the wrath of Poseidon, for the Doliones were his descendants. The Gegenees would be encountered by the Argonauts, the band of heroes who sailed on board the Argo during the Argonauts' voyage to Colchis. The Argonauts found safe anchorage off of the landmass and found a friendly welcome from the king of the Doliones, King Cyzicus. Lulled into a false sense of security by this friendly welcome, half of the Argonauts set off to explore mountain and slopes, whilst the remaining Argonauts brought their go into the harbor of Hytus. With the strength of the Argonauts divided in two, the Gegenees saw an opportunity to attack. The giants threw boulders blocking the harbor entrance, believing that their prey, the Argonauts, had now no means of escape. The Gegenees, though, did not know the type of men they were attacking, for the party that were with the Argo included Heracles, the greatest of all Greek heroes. Heracles took up his famous bow and unleashed arrow after arrow against the Gigantes, with many of the giants dying as the Hydra poison imbued arrows found their mark. The Gegenees retaliated, unleashing their own form of long-range weapons, and a fusillable of jagged rocks were thrown at Heracles and the other Argonauts, though none of the heroes were seriously injured. The attack of the Gegenees has been successfully delayed, and it was a delay long enough to ensure that the Argonauts, who had gone exploring upon the mountain, were able to return to the site of their comrades. Now, the Gegenees faced with the combined force of the Argonauts. The Gegenees were not cowards though, and time after time they rushed forward to attack. It was a massacre, for one by one the Gegenees fell to the weapons of the Argonauts, until there were no more giants left. Let us finish with the following saying. It is the mark of a divine mind to be always contemplating something noble. Democritus. That being said, remember guys to hit the like button and to subscribe to our channel, it would help us a lot. Thanks for watching and stay tuned for upcoming videos.